Your body. Taking out with the sun, we can't talk. walked away from who I was and who we were. Your lies so silent to my ear. Oh, you take it, take it, take it all. You take it, take it, take it all.
I don't play right. I'll put up a good fight. Just give me the word. I, uh-huh, uh-huh. You know I don't play. I'll put up a good fight. Just give me the word, like, you know I don't play right. I'll put up a good fight. You know I don't play right. You know I don't play right.
Badadan, bad from me. We'll be right back.
Here was the most fucking annoying music coming from my son's bedroom. I stormed into his room and asked him to turn it off, but he turned around and said, "Mum, fuck off. You wouldn't understand. This is hardcore." Fuck you and your hardcore. You and your hardcore. Fuck you and your hardcore. Your hardcore. Hardcore.
kids.
Is there a link between virtual violence and the real thing?
A new study finds the link between violent games and aggressive behavior in children.
Critics point to this, the appearance of weapons in video games, like this Remington assault rifle pictured in popular game Call of Duty.
Statistics are telling us that the more they play and the more they play aggressive games, they start thinking in an aggressive way and they have more aggressive attitudes.
The kinds of messages and images that they are putting in their minds, I think they're seeing that these are sources for huge acts of violence.
We see video games are actually being used as a scapegoat.
The problem is just the science, the data does not back up, I didn't have to have it on.
And so weapons in Call of Duty, weapons in Call of Duty, weapons in Call of Duty.
Oh, I feel stupid. Maybe I have time for drink. All right, I'll get up already. I love this effing gun, get it? Because it's effing fuck. Hey, Daisy. I love this effing gun.
Bye.
We have gathered here to join forces. Together as one, we are strong.
Lose that control!